And there you go with the reels and prefab hearts. That's going to be a hit for sure. All right, as you know, April the 13th, 6 o'clock, we're going to go right coast to coast, right across Australia, with the Australian Rock Awards. It's going to be a very exciting night. The votes are all being tabulated now, and everyone's sort of gripping their teeth. In fact, I was at the Sports Split Ends concert last night, and they're all sort of going like that, and what a fantastic concert that was. But don't miss out, April the 13th, 6 o'clock, coast to coast, right across Australia. It's going to be a good night. This guy here, and I've got to just review this album, because do you recognise this guy here? This was taken 8 years ago, and it's Michael Jackson, and later in the show, we're going to talk to Michael Jackson on the phone, so stay tuned. But there's Michael Jackson 8 years ago. All right. Now, one of the guys that I really got to like last year was a guy called Joe Jackson. Is she really going out with me? I mean, I was all... with him, actually. We were all up there singing and dancing with this one. This album, it's called I'm the Man. It's a fantastic little album. It's different from the last one, so if you're a Joe Jackson fan, go in, because you may or may not like this one. But let's have a listen to one track of it. It's a Different for Girls. Okay, Joe Jackson. Listen, here is an artist impression of one of the awards that are going to be awarded the night of the Rock Awards, and that's the TV Week Rock Award. So, as I say, look, watch out for it. It's going to be a great night. Would you believe in the discos these days, talking about 7 years ago with Michael Jackson, this was recorded about 11 years ago, and it's the Monkees. Anyone remember the Monkees?
Yeah!
You all remember the Monkees. Well, I tell you what, there are a couple of tracks that are becoming huge on the disco scene. I'm a Believer, Last Train to Clarksville, and Daydream Believer. This is the compilation album. Watch out for it, because I tell you what, they could almost become big again. All right? The Monkees revival. Would you believe that at all? Going back to 1980, one group that I reckon is unbelievable. We're going to show them in full next week. It's the Craze, discovered by Pete Townsend from The Who. Here it is, Going Through the Motion. The Craze. That song, Going Through the Motions by The Craze. One guy you probably know nothing about is a guy called John Townley. He's got an album out simply titled Townley, and the simple title does not reflect the music. This album is full of goodies, and we hope to have this guy out in a couple of weeks' time. It's a superb album. Do yourself a favour, go out and listen to it, and I'm sure you're going to like it. John Townley with the Townley album. All right. One guy that I've been raving about, we did an interview a couple of weeks ago with him, and some people said, they said, Molly, you were talking so hot and they were so cool. They are a pretty cool bunch of guys, but they're great on stage, great rock and roll. Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. They're going to tour here. They've got a single out at the moment that is boarding up the charts, Refugee. Have a look at this. Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, out soon. By the magic of television, I said soon, but I didn't realise it was this soon. Here it is, Sydney, April the 26th, Tom Petty, Brisbane the 29th, again Tom Petty, Melbourne May the 1st, Adelaide May the 3rd. Don't miss out on him, he's a great act. Saw him in America a couple of years ago with the Heartbreakers, and quite sensational. From the Dam to the Torpedoes album, here it is, Refugee, Tom Petty. Ooh. All right, there you go. Another guy you may not have heard anything about at all, and it's sort of a day of sort of albums that you probably know nothing about. This guy is called John Foxx. Now, a lot of people will say it's a takeoff of Gary Newman, but I don't think it is. And would you believe that when MI6 released Computer Games in London, the critics there had the audacity to say that they were taking off Gary Newman, which was a lot of, you know, old cobbler. But there you go. This album, do yourself again a favour. Have a listen to it, Metalmatic. It's another new album and you may like it. John Foxx. Here is a track off this particular album called Underpass.
Nobody I know.
Okay, that was John Foxx with Underpass. Now, last week we were raving about on the show about the success of one guy in America who sort of combines everything now, show business in total, and that's, of course, Mr. Michael Jackson. We finished the show off with him last week with Rock With You, the live concert version. This is the album that's caused the storm not only in Australia but right around the world. It's Michael's Off The Wall album, and hopefully we've got Michael in LA on the phone now. Let's have a... Oh, here we go. Hello, Michael.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
That's good. Now, listen, first of all, congratulations on the Off The Wall album. It's been an enormous success for you here in this country and also in America, of course. How does it feel like to have such a successful album?
Oh, it's a wonderful feeling because I always do my best and I'm very happy that the public accepted.
Right, now the first single off the album was Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. Can you just tell us a little about the recording of that track and especially all the dance steps you do in the film clips?
Well, Don't Stop Till You Get Enough, I wrote that song at home and it just came together and I decided to record it on the Off The Wall album. And when I sing it on stage, I just, everything I do comes spontaneously. It's nothing really planned, I just dance and it comes about.
Right, now, did you ever take dancing lessons at any stage? Because there's some pretty cool steps there.
Thank you. No, I've never had lessons before, but I just do what I feel, and it comes about.
We've absolutely knocked out with the vision of that. Now, where did you get the idea of wearing your dinner suit with your the sleeves rolled up?
Oh, that just was an idea we threw around with my manager and myself. To, you know, because I love that style, and when I dance on stage, my socks, you know, glitter. And
right.
Have a good time with the girls, you know, with the girls in the audience.
Right.
Love that.
Right, now, of course, that single was an enormous success everywhere in the world. Number one in America for so long, number one in Australia just recently. Did you expect it to do that well?
Boy, it's hard to say that I expected, but I'm very happy what's been happening. It's, now the album is over 4 million, which is quadruplet, I guess.
Wow.
You know, triple platinum. And I'm very happy. I thank everybody.
The Destiny album is doing enormous business out here now with Blame It On The Boogie and Shake Your Body To The Ground. When was that recorded, actually, that album?
That was recorded about, boy, a year ago.
Right.
And that was the Jackson's first time going in the studio writing and producing all the songs. And we gave it a try and it worked out great. The album is double platinum now, which is 2.5 million, and it's still doing well. And Shake Your Body Down to the Ground was a platinum song, as well as Blame It On The Boogie went gold here. And we've just been so happy about the whole thing, especially because we wrote and produced all the songs.
Now, when's the chance of you and the rest of your brothers coming out to Australia to tour?
Yes, we'll be coming there after we do this album. We'll be doing a European tour.
Right. Now, which album are you working on now, your own solo album or one with your brothers?
We're working on the Jackson's album, which is going to be my favorite. It's going to top them all.
You're that confident?
Excited about this one.
Right. And who's written the songs for that album?
We wrote all the songs. There's certain songs that I wrote by myself and certain songs that my other brother wrote and some that we all wrote. But we all together, we wrote all the songs, and we're really, really excited.
Right. Now, the other thing is, when you consider that, how long have your brothers been together now as a group?
Boy, I've been singing on stage since I was 5 years old.
Right.
And we've been singing together about 16 years. Baby, got the break, got the dance.
Now, how old are you now, being the veteran of show business?
21.
Oh, wow. That's ridiculous. Thank you very much, Michael, and thanks for being on Countdown.
I'll be looking forward to coming there.
All right. Take care and look after yourself, and don't work too hard.
Okay, bye.
All right, then. Bye. All right, let's go into Michael with his hit single, Rock With You.